So the topic is slip test. The purpose of this slip test is to identify or determine XD and XQ of that is synchronous reactance of salient pole machine. When D and Q axes are coming, that means the machine is salient pole. Okay. So let us understand how this test is performed and these parameters are identified with the help of lab setup. So this is the lab setup. Where slip means we have to maintain a relative velocity between field winding and armature winding, okay, which are the two parts of synchronous machine. So field winding velocity will be controlled by a DC motor with the help of field rheostat. If you vary the field rheostat, you can control the field winding speed, okay. So, and the next part is the armature part. Here you can see that the 3-phase AC supply of 50 Hz is given to armature part of synchronous machine. So in armature, there will be armature current, and the MMF which is created by this current will have a constant speed of 50 Hz. That is, NS will be equal to 1500 RPM. Fine. So in this machine, overall, the IF is zero, because the field winding is kept open. IF is zero. In this machine, there is only one current, that is armature current. Fine. So relative velocity is there between field winding and armature winding. Field winding is having speed through DC motor, and armature winding is having fixed speed, that is 1500 RPM. Fine. So now let us see the formulation. XD is equal to Vmax by Imin. That means when the machine axis coincides with the, that is armature axis coincides with the field pole, when it is along the D axis, there is minimum air gap between the two parts. Fine. There is minimum air gap. Minimum air gap means reluctance required to set up the flux is minimum, and the current which is required to set up the flux will also be minimum. Okay. That is why in the denominator there is minimum. Minimum means was armature current. Minimum armature current. Okay, fine. Next, because the current is minimum, that is why the voltage drop will also be minimum. So voltage will vary slightly. So that voltage is referred as Vmax. Fine. So next formula, that is quadrature axis reactance. When the machine coincides in quadrature, that is along the Q axis, there is larger gap. Larger gap means reluctance required to set up the flux in the air gap will also be large. If reluctance is large, so large amount of current is required to set up the air gap flux. Okay, that is why the current is maximum here. Voltage, because current is large, voltage drop will be large, so voltage is minimum. Okay, so that same thing can be seen here on the oscillogram. This A which is marked is D axis, and this one is Q axis. Okay, so D axis and Q axis. You can see on the D axis, the voltage is maximum. D axis, voltage is maximum. Again, we'll see through the formula. D axis, voltage is maximum. Okay, so D axis, voltage is maximum. Q axis, voltage is minimum. So this is Q axis. Q axis, here the voltage is minimum. Again, D axis, voltage maximum. Then the profile goes to be minimum. Maximum, minimum. There is swing in the voltmeter which is connected across the armature continuously. D axis, it will be maximum, and Q axis, it will be minimum. Okay. This is profile of armature current. Armature current in Q axis, it was, in D axis it was minimum. Okay, so you can see here D axis it is minimum, Q axis it is maximum. So the profile goes from minimum to maximum. Okay, again a profile goes minimum, then Q axis maximum, like this. Okay, if you properly observe these two waveform of armature voltage and armature current, you will find that the armature voltage profile variation or swinging is small as compared to ammeter. Again, I'll repeat my question, that if you properly see the profile, the armature voltage swinging or the variation is smaller, but the armature current profile is having nice swing. Okay, so profile is having nice swing. The reason behind the swing is that the voltage is having less swing. The reason is swing of ammeter is wide, whereas voltmeter has small swing. Where is that ammeter and voltmeter? Ammeter can be connected across any two line, and a voltmeter will be connected across any two line, and ammeter will be connected across any one line. Okay, so and voltmeter will have small swing because of low impedance drop in the leads and three phase variac. Okay, because the voltage drop is less as compared to the current requirement along D axis and Q axis. As we have discussed the formula, that there is continuous requirement if D axis is there, current requirement is less, and if Q axis is there, current requirement will be large due to small and higher air gap. So that is why the ammeter will swing more as compared to voltmeter. Okay, clear that point. Then one more thing, while performing this test, it is taken care that the slip test should be performed as small as slip it can be. For example, if the armature is having 1500 rpm speed, the field winding should not be, for example, 1400 rpm. It should be 1480 rpm or 1470 rpm. So less slip should be there between two parts. Again, I'll repeat that if the armature is having fixed speed of 1500 rpm, the field winding should not have large variation. It should not be 1400 rpm, 1300 rpm, like that. The speed should be 1470, 1480 or 1520, 1530, like that. Less slip should be there between two parts. If it is not like that, then the we know that in the field winding there are extra winding there, damper winding. So if the slip is more, the voltage will be induced in the damper winding, and that will lead to the error in the recordings of XD and XQ. Okay, but it is very difficult to maintain less slip. If while performing practical, we see that to maintain less slip, it is very difficult because we are nicely aware with the formulations of power of salient pole machine that. So we are aware with this formulation, where the formula says that the power of salient pole machine has two terms. First term is this exciting term, exciting power, and then the second term is the reluctance power. If you can remember, we have discussed this formulation. So exciting power depends upon EF is there. So exciting power will depend upon field current. But the second term, that is reluctance power, it does not depend on field current. Again, I repeat, reluctance power, the second term, it does not contain any term which is EF. So because of no EF, it is independent of field current. Even though the field current is zero, this power will be present in the machine. In salient pole machine, this amount of reluctance power will be present. Okay. So right now we have seen that the power formula of salient pole machine has reluctance power even if the field current is zero, because in this case we are maintaining IF to be zero. IF is zero, that means even if IF is zero, reluctance power will be there. And if you maintain the slip less, this reluctance power will be there in the machine, and it will bring the machine into synchronism. That means if you have maintained the speed of field winding to be 1470 and armature is 1500, so this reluctance power of machine will what it will do? It will bring the 1470 rpm speed to be 1500, and both the parts of the machine will be running at same speed, that is 1500 rpm. When both the parts will run at the same speed, that means there will be no swing in the meters. That means whatever reactance which will be calculated will be only D axis reactance, because both the parts are running at the same speed. That is not expected in this experiment. In this experiment, there has to be slip so that there will be continuous recording of I max and I min. If both the parts, field winding and armature winding, they are running at same speed, then there will be constant reading of current and voltage, which will give you only XD. you will not get XQ calculation by this experiment. So the requirement of the test is that the slip should be less, as well as the voltage which you are applying. In the formula we have seen that reluctance power, the numerator there was V. So voltage should be less. If voltage is large, the reluctance power will be large, and because of that reluctance power, even if you are maintaining slip, the machine by reluctance power, it will come to synchronous speed, and both the parts will run at the same speed. So the observation will be wrong in that case. Okay, so first requirement is slip should be less. Second requirement is the supplied voltage should be less in order to successful determination of XD and XQ. That's all.